be hard for me. It may be hard for you too, but this is a message I got. I was given permission a while ago to share it. It's about a year or so old. It's a message I got from, he said, let's just say a friend of mine I met through a prior line of work. He was a Marine and a badass one. This guy was a real deal. A quiet guy who never ever spoke about why he had this patina of just this wall you couldn't crack through, this crust around him you couldn't get through. And then one day I got this email from him. Keep in mind, this is a guy who never spoke about his feelings or what he did. He didn't go on campus pretending to be Chuck Norris in Invasion USA in my prior line of work. Never mentioned anything about it. And then one day I got this email. I want you to listen to this. It's going to be hard to get through. Hey, Dan, great podcast today. I really felt that. A lot of people don't understand what it's like coming home from combat after doing things for your country. We have to live with what we've done. I feel I forfeited any chance to see my daughters in the afterlife. When your ROEs were to smoke check anyone with a shovel and an orange bucket, including kids, it was like the Wild West. And your enemy changes you. You grow a hate inside you that you can't come to terms with. You watch your Marines die. You watch them get maimed, losing legs, arms, private parts, all the while knowing the locals knew where the IEDs and ambushes were, but they didn't tell you during the many shuras you sat in. Usually they were 15 to 20 pounders, which would take out a leg or both. Sometimes a hand and part of an arm if you were carrying your weapon at low ready. The worst was the 50 to 75 pounder that turned you into what we called the pink mist. We backed the truck up and put the pieces in the back using a poncho, and the kid next to him, who was in shock while dropping every ordnance we had from fixed rotary wing, artillery and mortars, we watched the local kids taunt us by raping dogs or cutting off their ears and tails in front of our faces, knowing we couldn't do anything about it. You hate them. You hate their women. You hate your chain of command who never leave the wire and yell at you when you get back because you had on white socks or cuffed your sleeve to see your wrist compass. I went 3 months without a shower. Then got yelled at for not having a haircut by some senior leadership who finally visited my forward operating base. I watched the first sergeant chew out a fellow squad leader because his pant leg crept up and showed his white socks, all while he was standing next to our makeshift helo pad with his dead Marine on a stretcher waiting for evacuation. You hate your government and the brass because they sent you out to clear the Taliban and you knew you would give it all back, but they wanted to give their combat action ribbon to get their full bird or first star. I would sit by a fire at night with a squad leader who lost his Marine to an IED drinking vodka. I was a functioning alcoholic in combat. You hate yourself because you feel that way. And yes, we gave it right back to the Taliban. So the 25 killed in action and more than 200 wounded in action was for nothing. Not for U.S. freedom, not for our way of life, not for Afghanistan democracy, not for Afghanistan's women's rights and gender studies. It was for nothing. You hate yourself because you lived. You hate yourself because your Marine killed himself when we got home and you couldn't prevent it. You hate yourself because you get drunk texts from your Marines telling you they love you and thanking you for what you did for them. But they're hurting because you had to give them orders to kill kids. I'll leave it here. You have to carry that hate for the rest of your life. It doesn't go away. It's actually gotten worse. I'm that savage you talked about that didn't care. I have nightmares every night and I hardly sleep. Your daughters die in bad ways in your dreams and you fear it's punishment for what you did. they might come true. So when we thank people for their service on days like today, I'd like you to keep that in your head. These men and women didn't go over there and throw a costume party. These guys came back with real damage, seeing things you and I will never have to see. Thank the Lord. So when you see these guys and you thank them for their service, now you know what their service entails. I'll never forget that email. There's actually more I had to leave out. Because believe it or not, however much that impacted your soul, it gets even worse in that email. Sorry to start the show heavy today, folks, but you know, when we say things like freedom isn't free and other things like that, you know, they may make cute bumper stickers, but freedom isn't free for a reason. It's at a cost. And candidly, it's not to people like me. I didn't serve overseas. The hell did I do? I didn't. I've been overseas. I didn't serve overseas. I wasn't in the military. Freedom isn't free. That cost was paid by someone else. Like this hero.